yan, right? And true, marketing skills can be somehow considered to be hard skills. The knowledge of strategy, the understanding of consumers, may halo hard skills yan. Pero yung engagement, like for example, when you're making a sale, soft skills would be very important, right? It is how you actually engage and connect with a person. So, may mga disciplines where these are both utilized. It's so hard to be good at one without the other, except for completely technical jobs. Like for example, actuarial. Okay, talagang kailangan hard skills ka. Diba? Actuarial mathematics eh. Kahit wala kang kaibigan, okay lang yan. Diba? Kasi puro numero ka naman eh, diba? Diba? May mga kilala tayong ganun. Pag natapilok, lalaglag yung mga numbers sa tenga. Diba? Pero, pwede nga kaibigan nila, libro. Diba? So, in many instances, unless it's totally a completely technical job, there has to be a mix of the two. And that's the reason why experience is very important. Kasi experience nandito eh. Dito yung education. Now, as Edward said, kailangan mo ba ng formal education to do this? No. You can learn it. And it's even tougher to learn it in the school of hard knocks. And that's the reason why, you know, I get amazed when somebody like Edward said, hindi mo ko kailangan yan eh. Right? Kasi dinaanan niya yun, learning about it the hard way. And that's the reason why the learning is what? It's a bit more practical. So yung mga gagawin slides ni Edward as to what he does, makikita nyo na rin sa libro yun eh, di ba? Pero hindi niya kinopia sa libro yun. Ginawa niya yun eh. 40 years yun eh. Right? Ngayon, kung gusto nyo mag 40 years din, huwag kayo magbasa. That's why he was telling you about the books that influenced him. That's why you have to read books that are written by great people around us, because you don't have to do the things going through the same experiences that they went through. If you can read about them, right? Then you become faster. So, kailangan ng development dito magkasunod. Now, when I get to say, ito na yung skills ko, talagang, syempre, upisan ko talaga yung marketing. I think all of you, if you're very active sa TRC, most of my talks, the topics that Brother Bo always give me, focuses on marketing and sales. Because I think I'm quite good at brand, okay? So, sa lahat ng napuntahan kong kumpanya, sa lahat ng na-handle ko, branding is easy for me. A lot of people would somehow, you know, not have a good grasp of branding. And a lot of people really can't understand it. They think it's a logo, they think it's a jingle, they think it's something that represents something. No, no. A brand is simply the essence of the promise of experience. It is the essence of that promise that people can expect to experience. It is a consummation of experiences and ideas that you connect to people and products. People, products, even entities. So, I tell a lot of people, do you remember the Ritz-Carlton logo? You know the Ritz-Carlton logo? I think that a lot of people know that it's a lion. Right? So, alam mo na, lion. Nakaharap sa kaliwa, sa kanan. Hey, hindi mo na alam eh, di ba? Kasi hindi mo na natatandaan yun. Pero when I say Ritz-Carlton, is it a cheap or an expensive hotel? Is it great or bad service? See, you associate, you forget the symbols. So, branding is that. And that's the reason why, even if it's called place branding, as I shared what we've done for Bataan, I shared what I've done for Ayala Land, and even for film life, di ba? Dati, ano sa film life? Ano yung technical? Hindi, simple. Ginawa namin yan. Anong plano mo? Usap tayo. Di ba ganun ang ginagawa mo lagi, di ba? Pag anong plano mo, usap tayo? Yun ang ginawa namin sa film, simple na namin. Kasi pag sinabi mong technical ka agad, sino makikipag-usap sa'yo? So, clearly, branding is one of the most important facets of marketing that I think I have a good grasp on. The value proposition, very important. What do you offer? What is unique about you? And why will I have to believe you? What are the reasons to believe you? Alam niyo ba, ang totoo ha, all the brands of Ayala Land, akala niyo ba pangalan lang yun? Premier, Alveo, Adidas. No. The there are five facets of the residential brands in Ayala. And out of those five, each and every brand accounts for something. Okay? So makikita nyo, Ayala Land Premier, distinctive location. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Nandun siya mismo sa mall. Dati, before everything, and I'll tell you this is a great example. Pagdating ko, ang binibenta namin, the residences at Greenbelt. You know where that is, right? Ngayon, yung isang kumpanya, yung Community Innovations at that time, which is unveiled today, was selling the columns at Legazpi Village. Right? So anong sabi ni columns at Legazpi Village? Live a few steps from everything. They came up with a slide. An ad. Live a few steps from everything. Sumagot si Ayala Land Premier. Live at the center of it all. Tumating ako, alam niyo yung analysis ko. Hindi kayo naglalaban, di ba kakomplikado? Di ba? Hindi kayo naglalaban. Eh, yung laban na yan, hindi lang sa marketing, pati sa land acquisition. Why? May nagbebenta ng lupa. Sino bibili niyan? Si Alveo? Si Abida? Si Premier. Nagkaroon ngayon ng rules. Pag within a certain radius, dapat ALP project yan. You don't have a right to buy within that radius if you're Alveo. If you're Abida, malayo na yun. Diba? ALB, center of the world. Abida, a walk away. Alveo pala, a walk away. Abida, a ride away. So, ganit na ganit yung reason ng mga tao Abida sa akin. Sabi, ano ko, why do you have to do this to us? Why? No. It's a brand promise. I don't want you to overpromise and underdeliver. Right? Let's be fair, you know, SM does a great thing with SM residences, right? Bike, air, jazz, wind. You know, ganon, di ba? Would you like to live in jazz, wind, air? So, ibig sabihin, hindi niya kayo pake. So, kailangan, pati yung mga pangalan na yan, hindi na pangalan yan. Di ba? Would you want to live in Bonifacio High Street? Usapan, di ba? Ay, kung rin binili mo yung studio, parang mayaman naman. Right? Pero pag sinabi, air residences. And the thing about this is this, and I'm just telling you this, no? I don't care about what the proposition is of SM and Ustaz. Both of them earn a lot of money. But you have to be very consistent. Hindi ka pwedeng SM, tapos magpaka-Ustaz ka. At hindi ka pwedeng Ustaz, at magpaka-SM. Yun ang hindi pwede. See, in marketing, there are no hard and fast rules, but you have to be very consistent. That is key. Consistency is key. So when you know your market, you have to know your value proposition. What do you offer? See, hindi mo pwedeng sabihin na you will be good for everyone. Right? The last thing the entrepreneur creates the biggest mistake out of is the fact that he thinks his whole world is his market. Big mistake. Second, that I think like my market. Alam mo yun ang pinakaisa kong mistake doon. Na alam mo ikaw, mag-iisip yung kliyente mo na kagaya-kagaya mo.